The Tempo 440 2.5. I got this specific one in a random box that MVP had sent me. So if you haven't seen that story, go check it out. But not only are we playing with this one, we're also going to be playing with the Circuit Challenge one. And I've got a challenge today that if I successfully do it, one of you guys will have this. I'll talk more about that here in a second. And then putting, we're going to use the Pilot. 25-1-1. You guys said that I was sleeping on this in the putter department. So we're going to be doing that. 9 holes, and we're playing in 2 different ways. This is day 3 of the snow. There are 0 footprints on this tee pad. I'm telling you, I'm the only disc golfer out here willing to make content for you guys. 405 feet, are we getting there? No, but we're taking best shot today, and we're playing the little point game. So it is best as I could have done. All right, thankfully these are some pretty bright discs. Not this one though. This one might be a pain to find. I'm trying my best to get there, but there's just no way. As far as the point system, if you don't know that, it's where off the tee, if we park the shot, that's worth 3 points. Circle 2 is only worth 1 point. Circle 1 is worth 2 points. That was kind of confusing as far as I explained it, but you'll get the idea. In this case, we have 0. It's a great way to start, but it is 405 feet. What can your boy do? And as far as the points, if we can get to 20 points, I'm choosing somebody to win this disc. I'm not sure how we're going to do the giveaway. I'll think of that on the next hole. We do have a little approach, though. Oh. Oh, we had a little bit of a skip. That was close enough. I'll try to run this one. No, I won't. That's, all right, right next to it. That's consistency right there. Oh my gosh, all this is ice. This is all frozen. Can I walk across it? Oh, nope, nope. It broke instantly. Okay. Yeah, we're not gonna mess with that. Never mind. In order to make this somewhat challenging, I'm only gonna putt once though. So we'll use my mystery box one, we'll call it. Here we go. Wind's picking up out of nowhere. First putt with the Pilot. Huh. Not too shabby. And we are on to the next hole. As far as the giveaway for the Tempo, like the video, take a screenshot that you're subscribed to my YouTube channel, DM me on Instagram. I'll choose somebody in 48 hours, I guess, to have this one. You guys were telling me that this one's expensive, so just in case I go broke, I need something to sell and make some money on. So here we go, 263 feet. This is where the point's gonna matter. We need to get to 20 points. Hypothetically, I don't wanna put this into existence, but if we do not hit 20 points, this will roll over into my next giveaway video, so it's not over yet, so. But that's not gonna happen, we're gonna get it. Here we go, 263 feet, backhand. Let's put this one close. It's a tasty little rip. It's all gonna matter of how it reacts on the ground. Ace runs today are gonna be a lot of fun because if I miss it, it's just gonna hit the snow and stick. If I leave it short, I can't rely on a 30-foot skip shot. Here we go, the money run Tempo. Oh baby, that's straight and then dumps. That's gotta be at least 3 points. This is so sick, you can literally see where it hit and then just kinda slid up. This one is in circle 1, that's 2 points. This dude up here, I'm gonna start calling it Cosmo and Wanda because it kinda has the colors. Cosmo and Wanda are literally parked. 3 points plus 2 points, quick math, 5. That's 5 points. I told you, we're gonna do this. Okay, really quick, just to talk about the discs, as far as backhands, because that's all I've thrown so far. I've played with these a few times. I love them. There's one part that I just stops it from being perfect. We'll get to it in a second, but quick profile of this thing. Board flat. Let me take off the gloves. Gloves. Take off the gloves. Backhand, I mean, wonderful. Grip is there. Feels so nice. Hitting it hard on hyzer, you guys saw how quickly it flipped the flat, but then still dumps at the end. I love it. I'm not really noticing any difference between the Circuit Challenge one and this one. I mean, there really shouldn't be any reason that they look different, right? I don't think so, but they feel good. My one issue though, is with the forehand. And we'll talk about that more in a second. We're on to hole 3. Don't be mad at me, but there ain't no way we're parking this one. I mean, it is 320 feet, but you have to go way out the gap and around. There's just no shot. If I really wanted to, I could maybe try to hit it straight down this gap, but I don't want to lose anything. We'll try the forehand. I'm gonna send one hugging this tree line on the right. No, I'm not. Okay. That sets us up for about a 180 footer. I want to try to squeeze something through that gap down there, but if I take a tree kick to the right, no, I'm not. Okay, here we go. Focus up. Let's hug this one a little bit more to the right this time. That is literally the best I could have done. literally the best I could have done. I even split the tree branches. I went so inside. I'm telling you, I threw the best shot I could have possibly thrown, and I'm probably 100 feet out. So my apologies, that's 0 points. Out of sympathy for every stroke that I shoot under par, we'll count that as a point also. So we'll do some more math at the end. I'm gonna throw this one on like a patent pending nose up flex shot. So see how this goes. Alrighty, back to the drawing board. We're gonna go forehand. Let's not do anything fancy. There we go. Look at that. And we're parked. I will say, I thought we were about to get a bogey. I'm pretty sure that this is the last hole on the front nine that we can't get because of distance. So we should be back to parking shots unless I just suck off the tee. So hole four. I'm not gonna lie, this course looks absolutely beautiful in the snow. And I'm glad we all get to enjoy this together. This is my first ever snow experience on the channel. I'm not sheltered. I've played in the snow before, but 280 feet. And this disc sets up pretty nice for it because it's just a straight shot that's humming out towards the right. So all I have to do is keep it underneath that ceiling. Uh-oh, spaghetti-o. Not, that's 0 points. Okay, Nate, come on, do it for the people. Do it for the people. Let's try that again. That's a lot better. Now it's short, and I got some crazy skips. But I think it's in at least circle two. I'm trying, guys, I'm trying. This one tried its best to scoot into circle one, but it didn't. Honestly, I did not think. I might have to step that other one off. That one actually might be in circle two. For the birdie, and for my first ever circle two putt with the pilot. Oh, that is so embarrassing. I'm gonna be out of frame for a second, but I'll be back. 20. 20 times three, that's in the circle. 2 points, ladies and gents. Oh, shoot, we got a melted tee pad. Let's freaking go, get out of here. All right, now we're about to go dummy. 250 feet. I'm gonna go with the forehand this time. Just a nice turnover shot, hitting it high, gonna have it slowly hold the turn off to the left. Mulligan, here we go. Wish me luck. That's the play. I still hit a tree, but it's definitely a point at least. You know, actually, I think I'm bailing on the whole forehand. We're gonna go backhand. Backhand with Cosmo and Wanda. I chose the hardest course to try and get 20 points. This one took me a couple of minutes to find. It's buried right underneath this plant. It is in circle two. Can we sneak an extra point though? No, guys, my hand's cold. I'm sorry. I'm trying. I'm freaking trying. I'm warmed up. Here we go. Locked and loaded. All right, I'm done making you guys wait any longer. The reason that this disc is not absolutely perfect, and keep this in mind, it's just my opinion. I can't speak for the public, but I wish it was just a little bit more overstable. That's it. It is not overstable enough. I don't know. I feel like if I pop this, I want it to be able to flex out in some way. You'll see it not on this hole, but the next hole, when I actually go for a forehand, I've got to put this on a lot of hyzer because it's going to try and flip up the whole way. And that's my only complaint. Backhand's phenomenal. I'm loving it for the backhand. But forehand, I mean, the grip is even there too. You guys like the grip? It fits perfect for the hand, but it's just, it's not understable, don't get me wrong, but like I said, I want that deflector beef. You know what I mean? Like I want, and you guys tell me, like try the pyro, all that stuff. The next video coming up, freaking airplanes, dude. Next video coming up, I'm gonna compare this to the pyro, so don't you worry. On the hole six, we are back to the snowy tee pads, 203 feet. Look how beautiful this hole looks. Okay, I'm not telling you guys which gap I'm going for, I'm just going for the basket. So here we go, circuit challenge up first. Yes. Sir. Believe it or not, that is the gap I was going for, I swear. I pinky promise. Okay, Cosmo and Wanda. Same gap. It's kind of hard to cross my fingers in these big old gloves. Here we go. Oh, grip lock baby. Well, at least we got one up here. That was a pretty solid shot. A little higher. It might have done you know what to tap in for our 15 footer. Birdie. Hello. Hello. How are you? I want a dog so bad. Three more holes left. They're by far the easiest three holes out here. We've got 10 points, plus or minus whatever I end up shooting at the end. So there's still a chance This hole is straight through the gap and kind of off to the left. I kind of have to miss this initial bunch of trees, but sets up nice for a backhand tempo shot. All I have to do is get a little lucky. That's lucky. If that rolled down the other side, we're definitely in circle one. Cosmo and Wanda, I'm gonna try not to hug it so inside this time. That's the line. That's like the pure way to the line. The first one, it got there, but it wasn't intentional. This tempo jumped its way down the hill to circle one, not parked, but I thought it was. This one's not parked either. Gosh, dude, the cold makes my jaw not work and I cannot speak normally. Birdie. Ugh. I need some gum or something. Get that jaw moving. Just in case something crazy happens, an ace is worth 5 points. 175 feet, straight shot. I want to do one backhand, one forehand. So circuit challenge is up first. Let me clear it. I got to take this one serious. We're cleaning off the spot. No slippage. I want this ace to be crazy. Oh my gosh. It's parked. Here's your 3 points. Dang it! If only I put more height on it, dude. I guess we try the forehand this time. Like I said, gotta put this on some hyzer because it will try and flip up. That's two great shots though. But man, third time's a charm. Why not? Never mind. I shouldn't have looked away. I have no idea where that went. It's snowy. Got my putter. This dude is in C1. Does not count. This guy is literally parked for 3 points. And if I can do math correctly, we should be at 19 points. So all I have to do is get this next shot in C2, and we don't even care about score. Oh my gosh, look how beautiful this hole is. 227 feet, downhill, through the trees, into the snow. Oh my gosh, it's so nice out here. I think I'm gonna do the backhand forehand combo again. So circuit challenge up first. Just gotta get inside C2. Bingo. That looked so good. I guess we're doing the forehand this time. Cosmo, Wanda, see what you got. See what I mean? Oh! I can't stand forehanding that thing. We'll try the pilot. I sound like a little baby. Here we go. Here's our extra mulligan shot. Can I just not hit a tree? Well, neither disc went inside C2, but counting score, I'll give it to you guys. I'm never doing that again, though. I feel like that's kind of cheating. We will play it out, see if we can do a little throw-in. See if we can toss this puppy in there. Okay. Okay, it's parked. Moment of truth. Can we throw it in for the birdie? All right, thank you guys for watching. Follow me on Instagram, shoot me that DM for a chance to win to Tempo. Peace.